In this video, I would like to present you with the evidence for mammography-induced cancers from data that my colleague Archie Bleyer and I have published recently in the New England Journal of Medicine. As you may know, for more than a decade, many studies from various countries have questioned the efficacy of mammography screening at reducing breast cancer mortality. Most of the mortality from breast cancer occurs because of metastasis, which are cancer cells spreading to another part of the body. To make a long story short, one of the starting points of this work has been the publication 5 years ago in the New England Journal of Medicine by Welch and colleagues of this very unexpected finding that mammography screening has not decreased the incidence of metastatic breast cancer in the USA, and this contrasts with the effect of prostate cancer screening, which has strongly reduced the incidence of metastatic prostate cancer. Welch and colleagues explain their findings by the fact that breast cancer is metastatic from the beginning. As an oncology scientist, I disagree. Even if cancer cells can metastasize from the beginning, the earlier they are removed, the better should be the outcome. And there is strong evidence that early surgery saves lives. So what happens? It has been argued by screening advocates that the rate of metastatic cancer is maintained constant by an increasing incidence of breast cancers in the USA. But then how to explain the evidence for poor efficacy of mammography screening on breast cancer mortality in other countries where screening began at different times, like Denmark, Sweden, or Netherlands? This would mean that in each country after mammography screening implementation, there is coincidentally an increase in cancer incidence. The simplest explanation is that the increase in cancer incidence that is observed is induced by mammography. This is not an extraordinary hypothesis, given that X-rays are known carcinogens, because they create breaks in the DNA, and that the low estimate of the number of radiation-induced cancers rests on a mathematical model based on hypotheses that have not been verified. However, the problem in testing this hypothesis is to distinguish between a true increase in cancer incidence and an apparent increase due to detection. Early detection translates into an increase of incidence in the youngest women. One way to make this distinction is to use data from a program where implementation of screening has been achieved in a very short time. This is the case in the United Kingdom. Implementation of mammography screening in 1988 in women aged from 50 to 64 years has resulted in a strong increase of the observed incidence of breast cancer in women aged from 50 to 54 years as a consequence of early detection. In 1996, this increase due to early detection is specific for this age group. The observed incidence of breast cancer going back to baseline level in the other age groups. Screening has been relatively stable after 1996, and detection similar, as shown by the absence of change in the 50 to 54-year-olds. But 10 years after, and several rounds of screening in 2005, one can observe a large increase in breast cancer incidence in older age groups, with an increase related to the number of previous screenings. When the maximum number of past mammograms has been reached for the age group considered, there is no further change. This is evidence for delayed cancers appearing after screening. The same observations can be made in other countries like the USA, France, and Sweden. In studying women older than 70 years, one could expect also a large number of cancers induced by mammography. However, one has to take into account that cancers are removed by early detection. To illustrate this effect of screening, we have taken advantage of the fact that two countries, the USA and France, had engaged in prostate cancer screening as well as in breast cancer screening. In this figure, you can see that prostate cancer screening has strongly reduced the incidence of cancer in men over 75 years, whereas breast cancer screening, although having caused millions of cancers to be removed, has been followed by an increase in breast cancer incidence. The same result is also observed in France, and you can also see that the excess of breast cancers cannot be due to detection, since screening is not recommended after 75 years. To conclude, mammography screening is followed by an excess of delayed cancers, which seems to occur between 5 years and 15 years after screening. These results call into question the alleged safety of X-ray imaging. I'll come back later on this question.